In this video lecture, we'll take a look at some examples of performing number system conversions between decimal, binary, and hex. Okay, let's get started. The various numbering systems we've already considered are nothing but different ways of representing the same numerical quantity of something. For example, the number 12 could be expressed in any of these forms: decimal, binary, hex, or in words. Obviously, all of these represent the same quantity of something. Given the three numbering systems that we've discussed, depending upon the situation, we might need to perform any one of these six number conversions. So how would we go about doing each of these? When performing conversions between number systems, such as for the number conversion assignment you'll have this week, you'll probably find it useful to have each of these tables on hand first. The first 16 decimal, binary, and hex patterns, the first 8 or so powers of 2, and the first 3 or 4 powers of 16. All of this information can be found on slides in the prior video lecture. Here on the right, we see the three primary number systems for us in computing, and the associated 6 possible conversions between them. And here on the left are the three possible techniques for making those conversions. We would use simple pattern substitution to go between binary and hex. We would use expanded notation to go from either binary or hex to decimal. And we would use the conversion algorithms to go from decimal to either binary or hex. Let's take a look at examples of each of these. The binary hex conversions are the simplest ones to make because they are literally simple table lookups. To go from binary to hex, simply break up the number into 4-bit chunks going from right to left, as shown here, and then left pad with zeros if needed to fill out the leftmost 4 bits, as shown here in blue. Once you've done this, simply do a binary to hex pattern substitution using simple table lookups. So binary 0001 is hex 1, binary 1010 is hex A, binary 1111 is of course hex F, and binary 1001 is hex 9. We'd probably represent the number with a leading 0x, as shown here, but that's all there is to it. Going in the other direction, the steps are the same. Hex B becomes binary 1011, hex 3 becomes binary 0011, hex B again is binary 1011, and hex E becomes binary 1110. And here is the equivalent binary number. Once again, these two conversions are nothing more than simple table lookups between binary and hex. So here are some examples of going from binary or hex to decimal. For example, let's say we wanted to convert this binary number to decimal. We start in the lowest value here, 2 to the 0, and figure out what the highest place value of 2 is that we require. So we have 2 to the 0, 2 to the 1, 2 to the 2, 2 to the 3, 2 to the 4, and 2 to the 5. So 2 to the 5 is the highest place value of 2 required. So then going from left to right this time, we'd express it in expanded notation as 1 times 2 to the 5th, 0 times 2 to the 4th, 0 times 2 to the 3rd, 1 times 2 to the 2nd, 1 times 2 to the 1st, and 0 times 2 to the 0. If we carry this expansion out arithmetically, we get 1 times 32, a 0 term, a 0 term, 1 times 4, 1 times 2, and another 0 term. If we carry this out fully and evaluate it, we'll get 32 plus 4 plus 2 equals 38. So now let's say we wanted to convert hex 14BD into decimal. Well, we do a similar thing as before, except now with a different base. We'd start at the right and figure out the highest power of 16 required. So 16 to the 0, 16 to the 1, 16 to the 2, 16 to the 3. So our highest required power of 16 is 16 to the 3rd. So now we go from left to right this time and apply each one of these coefficients to its base 16 place value. So we have 1 times 16 to the 3rd, 4 times 16 squared, b times 16, and d times 16 to the 0, or 1. The only tricky thing here is making the substitution that b is equal to 11 and d is equal to 13, but we can simply find this in a table lookup. If we carry this arithmetic out to its fullest extent, we get the sum of these terms, and ultimately this is our answer. So that's all there is to it. Just write both of these numbers in expanded notation and then fully evaluate the expanded notation until you get one final decimal result.